offense, I'm just saying this. You can disagree with me, you can disagree with all of them, the EDs or the marketing, you can disagree. Because each and every one of you is special. Okay? Everyone is special. Alan is special. Karin is special. All is special. Joseph also is our hiking IC. Right, you know the discovery trail that he did, very successful. In fact, some of the other agencies asked us to sell them the discovery, but I said no, we only need to sell to ERA. And we sold our life to ERA. Okay? So everyone is special, I touched on that already. Okay, I need you for the next few, 2 or 3 hours, you will become an expert. Okay? There is 6 agencies, no doubt about that, for this launch. There is 6 agencies, correct? Scary, no? It ain't scary, no? Scary, 6 agencies. Okay, but if you can absorb the knowledge today, right, you can become an expert. And if you become an expert, what happens? When people buy property, they automatically wake up and think of Philip. Right, just now ask a question. After ABSA, who closed? Only Philip. So she has built a branding there already. If I got buyer or what, I straight away call Philip. I will not call the rest.
Philip is not.
Sorry.
Philip is your Philip.
Hey, good, huh? That should be the way, no? You can tell me I'm wrong. Right? So, it's a branding. If you are an expert, I can be served by the lady over here. Serve. By the end of the day, I will buy. I'll check with her. Why? She closed before, man. The rest never closed, man. So, she must have something special to share, right? Alright? Agreed? Okay. So, I just touched on very fast one, 20 minutes. My time is only 20 minutes. New launch versus resale. What's the difference? We go straight into new launch versus resale. I go straight to the point. Okay? The payment scheme for new launch is how many percent now? Anybody? Okay. How many percent? 25. Alan, how many percent?
20.
20?
I don't know how you sell so many of these. You got an extra 5% ABSD. So it's 25. Okay, the extra cash is 25. But for new launch, but for resale, how many percent? Full, right? You got to pay full. So can I still cut the ABSD? No? I only pay 25%. The rest of the 75% I wait to GOP. Okay, one of the difference. So the pricing right now. If this pricing, I want to tell you, is because the developer bought this land during 2016 October, November, like that. And you know UOL, they have a famous architect, they have a high class architect, they have the best brand and everything. But do you think they will sell high price after this curve? Do you think so? If you are the developer, what kind of pricing will you sell? Especially after the park convention. Right? So developer has to sell, they have only 5 years to sell. Resale, I don't need to sell. Right, sometimes you see along the roads where there are some houses nobody stay one, then full of grass one, because I think the owner passed away or something like that. Right, so the resale can just stay there. And if you want to buy, you don't know what's going on with that resale. I'm not saying resale is lousy, but I'm just giving a comparison. Okay, choice unit. You see the A3 chart, right? You can choose, you like 0809, you like 0404, you still can choose. But if you go and buy a resale, you go and build a 0327, you must buy that specific unit only. Is that a difference? You see the difference? Right, so here you still have the choice of choosing different facing, different layout, and the unit number. Okay, you have to know this because the buyer that comes in will definitely choose between a resale and a new launch. But when you sell resale, you talk resale. That one will be the next project I will teach you how to do. But for this one, we talk about new launch first. Okay? Rental. When can you rent a new launch? A new launch when it's DOP? When? Okay. You can rent it during the 85% when you pay up the 85%. That means you are still owing the 15%. So if you actually sit down and calculate, you still profit that 15% then get there. But for resale, immediate. Okay, this one nothing to say. You pay 1 million, straight away you rent out, but you run the risk of vacancy. Capital appreciation, definitely new one, you have the first mover advantage. Right, I always share. I never got any site plan. Okay, I think you all a secret. You all know a secret.
Okay, during, for example, part of the loan on step 5, right? We see very, very high interest on step 5. But on the 14th, 15th floor to the 10th floor is... On the 14th to 15th floor is fully sold. So how to convince your buyer to go for the second floor? Right, so you tell the second floor buyer, the price is definitely lower than the 10th floor and the 11th floor one. Correct? Next time I buy now, I want to sell the 10th and 11th floor. Is it I made a profit? Correct? You understand what I'm trying to bring through? Sam, you understand? I also don't understand. Okay, so that's the capital appreciation part. That means immediately, first mover, anybody that wants to buy that stack, anybody that wants to buy that stack, surely have to buy from the low floor onwards. Okay? For resale, of course, it's the second hand relief. They make a profit over there. Based on my experience, normally you buy a property, you make about... First one, normally is about 200-300k. You all got buy properties before? The person he bought, opposite Potong Pasir, one of the project there, I bought about 900 plus, now worth about 1.1. So I already made the first mover. But then, what the new launch? So do you think I can make additional funds from it, additional money from it? Right? So these are the capital appreciation for new launch, and the cash outlay also is not much. Just go a bit faster. Both are applicable for the additional buyer stamp duty, correct? Correct?
Very serious.
Correct? Okay. So we have a longer list, right? That always people always like freehold versus 99 years list. But nowadays if you realize all the GLS and all the MLOCs are all 99 years. 99 years supposedly based on experience, it is always nearer to the MRT. Right? The only thing that is different is the valuation. For freehold, it stays there. But for 99 years, definitely the newer ones like 99, 98 years is worth more. Okay? For a 70 years old, like for example, Kensington, those areas, do you think it worth 1,000, 8,000, 9? PSM, we just go blunt, 1,000, 8,000, 9. Do you think it worth? No, right? No, right? Anyone selling Kensington here? Okay. Then the construction. Definitely I got, for example, here we have 726 units. If you do not study this product, I don't ever dream of selling, because as a developer, I would definitely price certain units, right? Certain units cheaper, certain units higher price. We call it loading. There is definitely some units like that. So if you can spot the cheapest unit, I advise you, you go and buy the unit yourself. You want to buy the unit? Don't go and buy it. If you don't buy the unit, you don't know how to sell them. So you need to spot where is the cheapest layout, cheapest spacing. Later we have to touch on the product. Of course, resale is always a bigger unit. But then again, bigger unit, like 1,005 square feet, you pay PSF on that 1,005 size. Okay? So resale, no matter how, is bigger than the current new launches. Okay, then we come on the 5th July. They did a little light. Anyone with me at the launch? Me, Joseph, almost died. Seriously, almost died. It's until the point where I pull one, let's say for example this guy, Mr. Low. I pull one Mr. Low out and his wife missing. And when I ask, who is Mr. Low? I bam, everybody raise up their hand. Seriously, this type of, I don't know whether it's fun or not. My face almost, I don't know why. But Joseph, lucky Joseph protect me. Otherwise, I'm dead with him. I also don't know why the government come out something almost make us die. Okay, just now Alan, take photo. Hey, okay, not take photo. 80% are breathing. 5%. When I did the Bud Colonial, 700,000, how much is the extra stamp duty? How much? Sam? 5% is how much?
30,000.
30,000? You bring down, not so scary. You say 75% to it, you know what I mean? what I mean or not? You always must use a mind to mind, right? Yeah, it's just additional 30,000. You buy one car only, how much? One BMW depreciation only 25,000. So use this kind of things to challenge. But don't challenge the buyer, you fight. Challenge, right? Challenge is very cheap. 790, your stamp duty extra 39,000. 39,000 can use CPF to pay one. Right? Later I'll show you one more chart where even though ABSD price is still going. Do you believe it or not, it's still going. Statistic. Okay? The next one, LTV. Alan, this one is for you. LTV, remember 75% for the first time. And that 5% must be cash or CPF. Okay, this one I think everybody should know already, right? I attended a lot of talks, a lot of things about this LTV. Okay, 1 million, just now I mentioned the 35k, okay. Just now we talked about 700k, but if let's say it's 1 million, it's only 50k more. Right, you digest this into your mind. If anything that was 1 million, it's just additional 50,000. So you break down, not so scary. People like to hear good things, cheap things and everything. So when you talk about 50k, people will still buy. Especially this SPR also. All is just additional 50,000. Okay? Can? Agree, Hong, okay, the stamp duty, you know, the Singapore, especially the share market. Do you all play shares? Do you all buy shares? We always follow Hang Seng, which is the Hong Kong market. And we always follow them, but no matter how, we will be following them. Okay? And their stamp duty is in fact 30% stamp duty. Okay, then we have Vancouver 15%. You digest this because at the time of the day you got to explain to the buyer. I cannot. I can teach you. At the end of the day, you will be the one on ground talking to the buyers. Okay? And we have Hong Kong 30,000 baht. See the header, Hong Kong property still surged by 55%, which is still up. People are still buying. If you play share market, a little tip. Whatever happens in Hang Seng, right, tomorrow Singapore will happen. Whatever happened to Dow Jones, right, US stock market, the next morning Singapore may or may not follow. So we definitely is follow Hong Kong. So compare yourself always with a further one. When you compare with Hong Kong, our 20% becomes very cheap. But we are still moving. And wow, this one you can see. Okay, this is a chart, maybe later then I send out. These are the cooling measures. You take a look from where you're sitting. All these are the ABSD, ABSD, SSB, whatever D. Okay? All building from June 09 until 2018. You see a growth? You still see a growth, no matter if it's 7 cooling measure, 10 cooling measure. It's still a growth. Right? If you see the blue line. All these are the non-landed private versus the volume. All these are the volume transacted. Then from 2014 to date, the previous ABSD, from March 04 onwards, also we still see a growth. No matter how, if you play stock and shares, it's like a tick. It's like a tick. If you know how to explain, when the property market goes down, it will definitely rebound like a tick. So today it went down and you see there's a tick here, sharp tick and the ABSD. So it will likely drop down a bit, but when it go up, it will go up as a tick. Agreed?
Very serious.
You know as a trainer, right? I see this type of face, I'm also scared. Really? Man. But if you start to ask questions, something I can share more. So you don't give me the stunned look. This is happening. It's really happening. Okay? What is this cooling measure for? It's not called stopping measure, right? It's just called cooling measure. What's cooling measure? It's not straight away handbrake. Huh? I go back to history 2005. There's an en bloc. What's the biggest en bloc 2005? Now still selling. Dilidan. Okay? It happens around here. Dilidan was one of the biggest, don't know how many billion around here. So in 2005 to 2007, en bloc, government see really serious. Why the developer making so much money? I must curb over here. I cut one time, not enough. 2009, what happened? The banks collapsed. Lehman Brothers, everything collapsed. Right? Straight away, bam, go down. So I told you the tick, like a tick. So the tick is happening again. And you see the growth for the next 3.5 years, the GLS is still moving. No matter how many, seven rounds, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong. 2015, we see a plunge again. What happened? I think the insurance, the U, one of the insurance collapsed also, right? Citibank or something like that. Correct? Then, when the en bloc frenzy start, where all this land come out, 2016, everybody start to en bloc. Even yesterday, 4 en blocs. So the cooling measure is for what? Can I ask you? It's not for you, it's for the developer. It's not for consumer. Cooling measures is only for the developer. Sell that to your buyers. Okay? This chart, you can just use it. It is only to curb and blocks. Not for the consumer. Consumer are still buying. Okay, we talk further of that. Then you calculate that 5%, which, right, Alan, 5%, right? Increase, extend the lead from 7 to 12. 2009 onwards, 16% increase in the property volume. So if you actually take up the calculator and calculate, we are talking about a 6 cooling measure, 4% already covered already. The growth has already covered your 5%. Make sense? Like I say, nobody's perfect. This one is the 8 of us are always thinking on how to curb that 5%. You base this graph you show to the buyer. Definitely you can cover it. And once you cover during 2012 to 2013, if you were to rent out your properties, for example, a 1 million property, you rent 3,000. The 3,000 for that per year is already 30,000. On top of that, you have another 4% increment. So no, whatever ABSD also no use one, is still moving on. Because why? Why is it still moving? Demand and supply. I will show you why. Okay? They don't have 2 slides. Okay, these are the percentage. We will send out these slides. You go into detail, then these are the percentage. So when you give this type of figure, do you become an expert? I suddenly, after doing the slides until 3 years, I suddenly become an expert. So when you become an expert, you become a doctor, right? The buyers can let other people serve. Never mind, just let them serve. But at the end of the day, you build properly your branding, the buyer will come to you. Make sense? Make sense? If I always share this analogy, analogy. If you are sick, our normal Singaporean, you just go to the pharmacy, buy what? Panadol. But if I keep getting sick and sick again, what am I gonna do? See specialist, right? So now the property got sick, you know, go to CC. You can see specialist like every one of us here. But to see specialist, you need to have this figure inside your head. How to explain the ABSD? Still increment. Talk so much, still increase. Does it make you like an expert? So, okay, then I move on. ABSD, still can buy? Still can buy? Raise, anyone? Still can buy or cannot buy after I talk for 10 minutes? Can, right? If you can talk like me, I think you sure post this one. You see the badge not here? I never see. You talk 10 minutes like this, sure can buy one. My badge is not the good badge, you can't see properly. Okay, all of us. So, how to profit from it, I already explained to you that 4% and the rental yield 3,000, 30,000 per year. Okay, how come people still buy it? I also don't know why, how come people still buy. After the curbs, right? Thursday, after the launch, after the night that all the 8 of us almost died, the next day, still people buying it. And I calculated 190. James, that one is how much? 190,000 stamp duty, right? The fellas just never blink one, okay? Get the PDI out. Weird, right? But I tell you why. I only tell you one reason why. The other reason you check the other. Okay, these are the types of buyers that is buying now. We made a study, right? And block buyers, see they really a lot of money. Right? Example, Rio Casa, Riverfront, those type of properties. They're getting about what? 1.7, 1.8 million. What is ABSD to them? Nothing. Totally nothing. upgraders. HDB upgraders, sell one, buy two, all the funny thing, restructuring. That one maybe we'll touch on further. Trustee. We see a lot of trustee. You buy a trust, buy for your kids. But if you have a trustee problem, please come to the DD because it's quite complicated. You need full cash. It still applies, ABSD still applies, because if you buy for the trust during that 3 years, if you sell, the government will still come back and claw you back for that ABSD. So that one's a bit complicated. Okay? Then foreign buyers will miss. I talked to one top agent, doesn't matter to them. Coming to buy South Beach, 20, 30 million properties, 5% to them is still nothing. You show them that Hong Kong chart, right? That one is 30% stamp duty in Hong Kong. Singapore is still doing okay, but the growth is still there, 5%. Okay. One of the reasons is demand and supply. Back to the original. 2012, we are doing about 5.3 million. This is the population in Singapore. 2020, we are reaching how many? 6 million, right? And in 2030, we will reach 6.9 million, which is because the demand and supply. That means these are the demands. These are the local. How many of you know what's the population in Singapore? No? Don't know? 5.6, 5.7 million as of now is our Singapore population. Versus targeted, just now I show you 2030. We are talking about 6.9 million. I just do a simple math calculation. 1.1 million growth and divided by 12 years, I get 92,500 population. But out of this 92,000, is 92,000 people going to buy properties? So one family, I break down again into 3.5 in a family. Can I break down? Or some got 5 children, 6 children, but I just based on the average, I need about 26,000 house to sell to this population during this time. Married couple, 2007 we have 19,000 married, 2008 20,000. We are talking about averagely 20,000 married. That means when I married, the next thing I'll do is buy a house, right? But some will buy HDB, 50% will buy HDB, balance I still need 11,000 private properties. Correct? Makes sense? We sat down together, we did this calculation. 75%, if let's say you say 75% by HDB, we still have 5,500 couples. So what is the average properties that is completed that these people will go and buy? These are the completed properties in Singapore right now. 2018, only 9,008. 2019, expected only 9,400 couples. So are we still shortage of house? We are, right? I need 26,000 or I need 11,000. That's why people are still coming in to buy. This is one of the reasons that we use the population to talk about the supply and demand. Make sense? Make sense, huh? Okay. So I have come to the end. I just want to give you 10 tips, right? Developer bought the cooling measures before this cooling measure ever come out. That means the price before that is supposed to be higher. Okay, but next week when we launch, definitely there will be special early bird discount. Okay? It has a good product and was launched at a higher price. But because of the curb, they have to readjust this price. James will touch on more on the property, on the basic and all that, the four garden house. Okay, if you buy, you know the Rolex, right? Anybody got the Rolex watch? You compare a Rolex watch and a Casio watch. Today I buy Casio watch $100. Tomorrow can I sell $100? Nobody will buy, right? So when you buy a product, always buy with value. If I buy a Rolex $10 today, maybe tomorrow I can sell $9,000 or $9,500 because it's a very good product. And product for property, location, developer, layouts, and the timing of the launch. Okay, then. Of course, I need to drill inside you. When you talk to the buyer, this is the first property that is going to be open after the curb. Means I'm very confident. Means the developer is confident. We are confident to launch this product. Will we see another rush or not? Do you think so? And see, do you think we'll see another rush like the Thursday, right? I think we will. We already see a rush in the agency of the number 6. We see a big rush in all the 6 agents. I told you, never mind, call 4 more, we'll make it 10. Correct. Call more, it's okay. Because anyway, I'm opening up after ABSD. But I see a difference in launches. I've been with so many launches for the past 10 years. Last time, our bookings can be 300, 500, 600. Now, you smell the 200, already count you. Everybody is coming for invites. So, market is changing, technology is changing, you see the video, everything is changing. If you don't change, you will die, You die, I go jobless. Correct? You definitely. So, where this technology, if you do not embrace it, you will lose out. Really? No more such the times when walk in, people buy, no more already. Buyers are not able to, okay, this one, I got my children, I got a daughter, 10 years old. She always go for the exam and the test paper, but she always fail. I say, never mind. You cannot score 100%, you try to score 70%. Right? So, same like property. You know where's the bottom, man? Anybody know where's the bottom? Anybody know where's the top? Nobody, I also don't know. But you score distinction 80% with the figures, you really okay with it. So I tell my daughter, 80% can, but then she's 10% also there. Okay? More opportunity, especially resale, new launch. A lot of opportunity coming up. Seller last time want to sell 2000 PSF, now become 1005. What do you think is opportunity? Especially the new agents, sometimes it's a little bit. Because when we share this type of thing, they really reach out. Only those old ones, I go for holiday for 2 months, 3 months, let the ABSD set up. But you're wrong. You're really wrong, no? Market is still moving, be it you are experienced or not. In fact, past colonial, 80% all the new agents. Then the experienced one, sit down there, waiting for the ABSD to sit in. Funny, right? Really funny, right? Okay? Then I will. Developer will price their properties reasonably. This developer, I think they will price at 3 phases. The phase 1, definitely there is early bird discount, 100%. But commission sure jialat lah. Confirm lah. I just tell you first, I don't want the Chinese, 我跳了黄河也洗不清. Later I call 500 people come in, then the commission to the room is free. Wow, see. Right? But you buy a good product. Right, you're buying a good product with integrity. You know the exit strategy for this. Same thing, like I told you, outside we are doing 2,000 PSF, 1,007, 1,008. I hear go at 1,006, I tell the buyer, I buy 1,006 now, next time I sell 1,005, which is transacted already. Do I make money? So you sell with integrity, the buyer next time for you, for rent, for everything, they'll come back and do it for you. Right? Sell with the heart. I feel the basis for experience. Last time I don't sell by the heart, I put in just a queue. But today I still receive the SMA, I want you to bluff me, I want to sue you, I get a lawyer letter on. Then I'm thinking, no wonder my daughter keep failing. Seriously, no joke. Really no joke, now I'm seeing that. This time, I sold consistent 7,000 PSF. Now the girl cannot rent, then poor doctor retired. But I'm facing it with your daughter and all that. So you brand yourself as a pro. You brand yourself as a pro. This is only 15 minutes. I only have 15 to 20 minutes that I can share with you. Right? If you really want to learn more, you join us in Trivalor, pay the $300, then I share with you more. Okay? So the next one I'll hand over to Marvin, very analytical person. He will give you more graph. More graphs, more things. Do you want more graphs or more statistics? Alright, he's a statistics person. Then after that, we'll talk about the product, which is James. No clap.
It's okay. Alright, can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
Can I? Okay. So, how many of you are here to attend training one? Please, right? Attend training, Okay, how many of you are here to make money on this? Okay. So those attend training one, thank you very much. Just to attend training. The rest of you are here to make money. Okay. I realize for all my training, there's always a better one. Okay? Those people who sit closer tend to close faster. Those people who sit behind always, because they cannot see the chart, they cannot see, then they pay attention also like Yaguku, you know, cannot understand. Okay? So I think I give you 10 seconds. You all decide whether you want to close later or close faster. Up to you, 10 seconds. I turn around. Normally when I'm late for meetings, how many of you will go to the back of the class or go to the front of the room? Who will go to the back of the room when you are late? Okay? If you observe me, when I'm late, I always go to the front. I don't care, I sit in front. Okay, because that's the best part. That's where the opportunity is. If today I say the first person, I take out $50, first person who come and get it, I will take the $50. The one at the back got no chance, understand? Every time to give freebie, the speaker want to give freebie, it's always the front people who get it. So it's always the case. So the size of the PowerPoint also is catered to the front people. The back people, we know you are just here to attend only. The front people will see very clearly, the back people cannot see very clearly. Always the case. Okay, am I too loud? I think I'm too loud. Testing, is this better? Better? No, don't think so. Testing. Up and down. Alright. So, I never change, you know. The people still, never mind. It means that you all decided. This time I saw somebody came a bit late and came to the front and said, that's a good example. Okay, so how many of you attended our PC training? PC training. Those raise your hand means you understand what I'm talking about, means you got attended. Okay, do you all use the slide in your presentation? Okay, this is the whole point. Actually, I have a whole stack of presentation, but every time when I meet my client, any buyer, anyone with a problem, I just take out my PC kit. Okay, because at the end of the day, we just want to go straight to the point and address the most important thing on the heart. Can I make money from this amount? For example, right? Everything is fluff, You say good architect, I also have good architect, but maybe this one better, Okay, but at the end of the day, your buyer want to make money, am I right? And if you can convince your buyer that they can make money, then there's a high chance you will close, am I right? Because they want to make money. Now they have to pay so much cost, at the end of the day, they want to make money. So today, if you pay attention, okay, PC, how many points did I give you all? PC. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, I gave you all 3 points. 3 points, we sold 50%, 50%. So now I give you 5 points today, okay? 5 points, we will sell more than 20%, okay? Okay, give me a round of applause. Okay, so the teams have come up with a system to help you all. Basically, it's to showcase, to select, and to secure. So I will be covering the showcase today, so that you all will know how to show the treatment to your buyers. Okay, so pay attention, we're going for a ride. Alright, so what are the factors that will make the Triver a good investment? Anybody? What is the one thing that will make it a good investment? Anyone? Come on, come on. Location. Is the location good? Very good. Why? Riverfront. Oh, so don't use Riverfront. Mr. Liang, don't lie. Riverview Frontage. Okay, very good. Okay. So, very good location. Okay. Then, got good school or not? Yes. Got good schools or not? Yes. Okay. What else? Do Good Asia Awards. What is that? Wow, a lot of awards being won by the architect. Am I right? So, other architect also good. My architect also good, but mine got awards. So which one is Buddha? Okay. So the retriever got Buddha, Buddha. Okay, what other factors that make retriever a good investment?
Ventilation.
Maximize light. Okay. These are actually selling features, right, for the property, yeah? But how to show this to the buyer that they can make money from maximized light, maximized ventilation? You can't, right? So you can't really show this. This one is more of the select the time, then you go to it. But now I want to showcase. How to showcase? What other thing can we showcase about the trigger? Come on. Landscaping. Oh, the landscaping is very nice, but that one also tied to what architecture, right? Tied to architecture. This architect will have this kind of landscaping, something like that. Okay, so thank you for that. Actually, there's a bit of consensus here, right? We have a very good product, am I right? Very, very good product. In fact, I think it's a very lovely product. Can stay for a long time. Who agree? Raise your hands. Okay, 50%. Those who don't agree means what? Not so nice. Normal. Okay. Haven't seen yet. Okay, can understand. So I'm going to go straight to the first one. Actually, after looking at all the selling points for the retriever, I think there's something that we can really be proud of. And this is the thing. The architect. Really, the architect. Okay, we must play this card. Because this architect is really, 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 very good. Okay? Very, very good. Woha, alright? So, is there a laser? Okay, not very strong. Okay, so there's a very good architect. And let me read from the Straits Times. Often considered to be Singapore's best architecture firm. Hey, you show this to the buyer first. Huh? Second thing, award-winning retirement village picked up the Building of the Year award for the development. Hey, at the get-go, I already have a very premium designer. It's like buying Prada. Prada is a brand or a person? Brand, but behind that there's a person, right? Correct? And that person actually tells you a certain prestige. So they command such a high price. Okay? Chosen designer of the year. First time Singapore architect designer has been awarded this title. Okay, so you can be proud as a homegrown architect. Okay, and they have been winning awards. Okay, so OMA founders back prestigious award design. Okay, this is actually quite new. It's a UOL and WOHA, one of the collaboration. What project is this? Park Royal Pickering at Park Royal. Correct? Right? Okay, where can you find this? The Kau Water. Okay, Kereta Ahie, okay, Chinatown. Alright, so it is a living and breathing architecture. Hey, sometimes you must make your client laugh. They come all the way, you know, walk from the MRT, 1 minute only. They come, then you must entertain them a bit. Okay, they also recently got this best tall building worldwide. Hello, tall building worldwide. There are so many tall buildings. They are the best tall building worldwide. Okay, amazing, right? Oasia Hotel named best tall building worldwide 2018. Wow, amazing by WOHA. All right. Not only that, HDB they also dominate. Which one is this? Skyview at Dawson by WOHA. Look at the architecture, come on. This HDB is to die for. Oh. So, amazing. So you can read this. I purposely put this here so that you can just continue that. But you all go back and read one time. So, at the end of the day, this architect has won so many awards that when I go to their website and look at the page of the awards, it is only the beginning. Can you imagine if we scroll down how many awards they have? Okay, question is, do you think the thriver will also get awards? Well, so what does it mean? Mr. Buyer, if you buy this property, before you win any award, and after you win any award, do you think the price will be different? Each time there is a mention, everybody go to Google, then the wife say, hey, come, we go and buy this one, come, we go and have a look at this one. Few years later, another award come, it will. Because this architecture is not on the year they DOP, then they win the award. When they design, they win the award. When they are building, they win the award. After they complete, they win the award. Complete very long, already still win the award. That is the kind of architect that is actually developing and building the driver. Okay? So, bear in mind, please point to the red square and show your buyer. If you want, bring your iPad and scroll down and run for them to see. Okay? So, is the quality assured, ladies and gentlemen? Okay? Is the popularity assured, ladies and gentlemen? Assured, there will be people who want just because it is by Oha. Can? Agree? Okay. So, it's not the first time that you all partnered with Oha for residential properties. So, there were actually two other residential properties that UOL partnered with Oha. We know Pickering, it's not a residential, it's a hotel. So now we look at Newton Suites. Hey, got similar design concept. You all see the green architecture, the breathing architecture. Okay, then Mr. Liang was saying that they actually push out the greenery, right? But in the thriver, they push it inside, right? Am I right? Every unit, when you're walking, now they're putting up the greenery. When you're walking to the lift, you walk past the greenery. Okay? So it's a very nice concept, Newton Suites. Okay, TOP which year? 2000 something. Okay, 2005. One moment rise, also 2000 something. Okay, one moment rise. So these two are by them. But how did they perform in the market? You all know that. Let's have a look. How come it doesn't go to the next slide? Okay, they started selling in 2001. Up to today, he has appreciated 75%. If you bought at launch, did you make money? Okay, first one. Let's see, second one. Hey, actually, you see, they buy at a higher point, right now. Then it went down, right now. But it still appreciate, right? Also doesn't matter. This one, when the quality is good, will make money. Okay, let's go at the next one. Newton Suites. Wow! Appreciated 134% since they launched. 2004 to 2017. Make money or lose money? Make money. So you buy already with a good architect, with a good brand, with a collector's item status. Will it actually appreciate? Yeah, it will. Oh, okay, thanks. Alright. So this is very, very important. Okay? So what about the driver? Okay, it has the same architect, same developer, okay, and giving you a good quality product. We know that product and location is very important, right? You have a good location, poor product also cannot make money. Right now. Good location, good product, poor location also cannot make money. Now we have good location, we have good product. Okay, so what about the thriver? So the thriver, firstly, top brand, UOL. Look at all their products. Very, very good quality. Second thing, world-renowned architect, Oha. Third, the largest international agency listed in Singapore. International, okay? ERA marketing it also. UOL partner with Oha, partner with ERA to sell you this product. Do you think we'll sell lousy products, ladies and gentlemen? You are from ERA, do we sell lousy products? No, we do not, okay? So it's a rare, unique, premium practice item that will appreciate over time. Just like if you buy a... What kind of watch will appreciate over time? Ask Sandy, she has a watch. Okay, she don't want to review. Okay? The start with R, what is that one called? A Rolex. Oh, if you buy an old Rolex today, will appreciate on the price. Yes, because went very rare and very prestigious. Oh, what about Patek Philippe? Oh, very nice. Oh, somebody not have it, that means for a few years. Okay, so likewise, if you buy this product, will it appreciate? You ask your buyer. Do you think it will appreciate? You don't see that. You answer. Will it appreciate? 100%. Okay. Where is your check? Can I? Okay, second thing, now that we have established that we have a very, very good architect, that's a very good selling point because everybody has good architect. Correct now? But ours is the screen not enough to show you the list of awards, that kind of architect, the good architect. Alright? So now we have price and value proposition. Okay, this is very important. To the investor, is the price important? Am I buying at the right price? Am I buying at the right price? You all know the price? You all know the price? You don't know the price? Okay? But how do you talk about the price without knowing the price? Anybody? Compare with the nearby. Okay? We have the word of Mr. Leung that it will be attractive for the first movers. Am I right? Okay, attractive means, is there any way to understand, other way to understand attractive? If, for example, now the market price is $1,000 and I sell you at $1,200, is it attractive? Not really, right? Okay, so if the market price, transacted price is at $1,000 and I sell at $950 for a very good product, is it attractive? Can be considered attractive. So I think there's only one way to understand attractive. Okay, so we talk about the market benchmark right now. Okay, very important. Okay, so which projects are we looking at? First one, we have the Straits Times reporting that Woodley Residences will be launching their 2 to 4 bedroom units at above 2,000 per square foot when the development is launched. When I see this slide, I'll teach you how to use this slide, okay? Always ask the buyer to read the red color one. Okay, so we practice, buyer, can you read the red color box?
Practice.
2 to 4
bedroom
has
to be priced at 2,000 per square foot when it's launched.
Okay, Mr. Buyer, do you see the word average? Again, Mr. Buyer, do you see the word average or not?
No.
No, okay. Mr. Buyer, what does it mean? What is the PSF of the biggest and the smallest unit minimum?
Above
2,000. Oh. Okay, you all see how I do it? You must do it this way. Let them read and then ask them, do they see the word average? They will say don't have. Then I say, this is SPH product. Reported by SPH newspaper. Don't have the word average. Only the word above. Mr. Buyer. Hey, suddenly all, how come I never buy back the word? Alright. Then second thing, we also know Park Colonial launched on the 5th of July. And what was the transacted average of that one night? 1,730. Okay, so actually we have a very, very good gauge of the market. But I tell you, this is not going to tell the whole story. You know why not? Because of the next one will tell the whole story. Let me show you the transacted prices for Park Colonial. 1 bedroom. Can you see the PSM? 1,730 average. What does it mean, ladies and gentlemen? 2,000 plus. Still buy like crazy. Okay? Can I? Second one, you show the buyer. What does it mean, 1,730 average? Oh, you see, 5th of July, right? 7th of July, still got people buy at 1,009. Okay? What does it mean? Don't care about ABS. Okay, so Do you realize that the transacted prices have already hit 1,900 to 2,000? Okay? Okay? When they launch the SPH, minimum 2,000, assume that they launch at 2,000 minimum, what price will the one bedroom be pricing at? 2,000? How many of you say 2,000? 2,001? 2,002? 2,003? Don't raise hand no matter what. 2,004? Wait, really? 2005? Still don't raise. 2006? Still haven't yet. Wow, you're all very scary. No wonder the government come up with cooling measure. Because you all don't raise your hand. Okay? So, 1,009 per square foot, 2 bedroom. Why did I emphasize on the 1 and 2 bedroom, ladies and gentlemen? Trivial, what is the percentage of 1 and 2 bedroom? More than the 3 and 4 bedroom, right? Yes? So we have to measure apple with apple. Don't look at the 1730 PSF and think that that is the 1. You must highlight to your buyer. These are all transacted prices nearby. And they got nothing. You have everything. You are in a mature area. You are closer to the city. My goodness. And you have the river frontage. 220 meters. 3 bedroom, also 1,008. Wow, scary. Today market, District 13, what is the comfortable PSF right now? 1,007, 1,008, 1,009. Comfortable. Still will have people buy. Still will have a lot of people buy. Okay? So we move forward. 4 bedroom, okay. I always show very real data. So this is what I got. Alright, so you can show it to them. Okay, moving forward. Resale, we are looking at 1 bedroom transacting already at 1,006, 1,007 already. Right now. Can resale one? Resale one. Hey, those who bought at 2,000 per square foot, how much can they sell? Those who bought at 2,000. How much does it sell? Sell at 2,000, right? Buy 2,000, sell at 2,000. Donnie, what do you think?
2,002.
Minimum must earn $200, right? But if they pay ABSD, you think they have to earn more? They have to earn more. So maybe $200 to $300 minimum. Okay? So resale market next time. From 1,006 to go to 2,000 to where? Hey, can you understand? They have to sell at 2,002 or 2,003, no? Next time resale market in District 13 will be very short one. Almost like today's Orchard, actually, is already Orchard Road pricing already. Wow, scary man. What is so exciting about District 13? I don't know. Okay, so anyway, these are the pricing. You can see even 2,000 per square foot. Okay, transacted resale market. 2,000 per square foot. And then you have 1,500 for the 4-bedroom. Okay, so these are the transacted pricing. So, any further capital upside, okay? I think you all will recall this. Basically, you can see that this is Rain Tree Gardens. They are purchase price. They are the lowest of the lot. There are basically 5 plots that will have to launch in District 13 in the coming years. Okay, have to launch. So, the red color is the break even, the green color is their estimated launch price. Okay, so more or less, if based on this is correct, if this is correct, right? Then if Kajima launch at 2,000, what is the upside for your buyer? Around $350 average. But then that this one is average. This one is average. The Kajima is the minimum. I don't know what is the average. Okay? Alright, then Park Colony we about 1,730. So that is actually very good pricing already because we estimated 1,008. This slide our COO Marcus Chu gave us at the beginning of the year. So actually quite accurate. I think ERA very powerful, we can read the future very well. Okay? So Woodley residences 2,000. If you want to understand how to calculate this one become 2,000, ask any one of us later on. Okay, and then San Jose will have to launch at 2003. What does it mean, Mr. Buyer? If they launch at 2003, you buy 2003, how much must they sell? 2005, minimum lah, minimum lah, give it minimum lah. But I won't be so satisfied. I think I will go at least for 2006 lah. So what is the future transacted price in District 13? Ladies and gentlemen, 2006. And then if you buy 1,650, how much will you? Wow! If you buy and hold your good property in good location, which is your chamber, over time, can you foresee your capital gain, Mr. Buyer? Hey, no clap. Clap already, now, yeah. Okay, but second point again. Yeah. Okay, so this one, standard, you will have to look at it yourself. Alright. So the third point I want to tell you is that Potong Pasir is an area with very, very good rental yield. And this chart will show you something very interesting. You see all these properties here, they are near to which MRT station? Potong Pasir MRT station. And can you see the rental yield over a 1 year period? What they are enjoying right now, based on transaction, data from SRS analyzer, not me. Is this good for a new condo? Very, very good, very good. And I want to show you new condo. You know why? In some areas, the new condo, the rental yield really suck. Agree? Because too much supply. Over here, a lot of supply, yet are still very good. Means under supply, right? If a lot of supply are still very good, must be under supply, right? Why? Because close to the city, man. So now you have river frontage some more. Wow, very different already. Very different, huh? Okay. So I give you the point 10 already. So triple will be 50% sold. Okay? Now I'm gonna push beyond 50%. Let's see. The fourth point. Instead of only BW development team. You have one more, Kallang River Transportation. Okay? This is the Bidadari Transportation. I just want to explain how to use this chart. Very simple. Mr. Meyer, this is what the government plan to do. Okay? In Woodley. Question is, when all these things are ready, will it appreciate in terms of the value? Yes, sir? Okay, question is, whose money did they use to build this? Mr. Meyer. Huh? How come you know? PPC, okay. All those people say is government money. It's not government money, it's your money and my money. Taxpayer money used to do all the infrastructure, but who get to gain?
You get to gain.
If you buy, then you get to gain. If you don't buy in this area, you won't get to gain. Am I right? Yes? You go and buy Malaysia, your money spent here, this thing will be nothing to do with you because you're in Malaysia. Am I right? So you have to buy here or nearby in order to benefit from this transformation, which is Bidadari. Okay? Can? Now let me show you the Kallang River transformation. Okay? This is the Kallang River. Go all the way up. Then I look at it, basically Potong Pasir MRT is here. So where's the river? Should be where? About here. River. So river tend to gain from two of the transformation. This one and this one. Widening of the CDE crossing. Okay? Then you can see the CDE crossing on the top and you can see people walking below, running below. Wow. Must be something very beautiful. If not, government won't announce. If it's just starting, nothing, small thing. Should I announce? Nothing to announce. So government announce. Second one is the PIE bridge. I don't know what it is also. Okay, but wait for more announcement. So anyway, when these things are starting to build, will it affect your pricing already? Yes or no? Yes, will. Okay. So your buyer now have a very, very good product. Buying at a very, very good price with a lot of upside built into it already. Then some more, now the government say I blow value into you by giving you confirm one, will change one, you know, because this one going to work with another country, one, this one, they decide, they move, that's it, it will be done, it will happen. When it happens, what will happen to the value of the property? Increase. Mr. Buyer, ready to buy? Yeah. Okay, next one. Last one is, this one, you must have analyzer, then you can see properly. So I have analyzer, so I did this. Oh, I saw something very beautiful. And this is my final point. You know what, the Kallang River is this blue thing here. This one, this blue one. This is the Kallang River. Okay, I show you something. Anything with a building is a private property. Private property. Okay? If it's not, then it's not private property. Okay? Understand? You see, why so many private property over here? What's the reason? River frontage, right? River frontage, right? All private property, right? Can I ask you, river is here. How many private property is sharing the river with you? Oh my goodness! You are the only one, Mr. Buyer! You stand alone, you know! The whole river is yours, You buy the river, I give you a river! Here you have to share. It's like a public toilet. Versus master bathroom. No jamming, don't share with them, okay? Don't share with them, that's not private. Now I'm talking private. I'm gonna say, sorry, okay, let me explain something. HDB valuation given by who? If the whole area, the price go up, who benefit? Private or HDB? That's all. I'm going to say that. Understand? Wow. You buy a river, you get a river. The river is the first and only private condominium in its own land. Beautiful or not? Confident or not? Wow. You are a... River, Kallang River side, URA ma, okay, URA, UOL, ERA, River. You buy, make money, come back, buy me coffee, can? Okay, so that's it, thank you very much. Okay. I still haven't finished selling y'all. One more thing.
Come on. No, must take a look at this drone. It's very,
very nice. Yeah. He will help me. Just play the three video. Okay, this one only C, I won't send you all. This one won't send you all. You'll see first. Okay, play first. Wow. It must have music, but no music. Just imagine. This is the view that you're going to get. High floor, 19th floor, 20th floor. Okay, next one. Okay, next one, I'm going to show you the 360 view from the side. This is what you'll see. See. Wow. Hey, the river view nice or not? Exclusively to you, no? This spot is a healthcare under master plan. Another value. That side going to widen. This is west facing. Nice or not? West facing nice or not?
Nice.
Low rise. Unblocked to lay park. What development is this? 2,000 per square foot on the room. Peak Park Colonial. Okay. Wow. 7 minutes walk to the MRT station. Correct, Angelina, you walk, right? 7 minutes walk, Can? Nice or not? Okay, so which facing one do you sell? River facing, huh?
Yes.
River facing. About 70% river facing, huh? 73. Okay, this one is to show you a bit more direct view of the river. Imagine you buy facing this side, then this is the river that you see. On this side also, there will be a setback. Wow, fantastic. I tell you, river must buy west facing, then the light comes very nice. Correct?
Very, very nice.
So actually, the developer Woha decided to build this design this way. Then it must be good, right? Correct? Right? Never make mistake, because they are award-winning, multiple award-winning architect. Okay, thank you very much.